Hey everyone, welcome back with another session of Geography. So today we'll continue the same chapter, that is Power Resources. Now, as we have discussed about the different conventional sources of energy in the previous session, so today we will discuss about all the non-conventional sources of energy. Alright, or you can say the unconventional power resources. Alright, so let's start. Now, the power resources which are not commonly used are called non-conventional power resources. Alright, now non-conventional sources of power are inexhaustible in nature. Alright, now they are also known as alternative sources of energy. Now, if you see for examples like solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, so all these are like examples of these non-conventional power resources. Okay. So we will discuss about them one by one. Now first and foremost we have, that is the wind energy. Now we all know that wind power has been used for centuries to navigate ships. Alright, nowadays it's like used to generate electricity with the help of windmills. Now the high speed winds rotate the windmill, which is connected to a generator and thus spins the generator to produce electricity. Alright, now if you see, winds are mostly found in the hilly and coastal areas. Now, countries like Netherlands, Denmark, Germany, Spain, UK and USA, these are famous for wind energy production. And in India, if you see, in India, wind farms have been developed in Tamil Nadu, Rajasthan and along the coast of Gujarat. Alright, so next we have, that is the solar energy. Now we all know that the sun's energy is basically limitless. So it is widely available in the tropical regions as they receive abundant sunshine. Now it can be trapped in solar cells. And further, these solar cells are joined to form solar panels, now which in turn produce electricity. Now it's also used for lighting, cooking and heating, and sometimes also for cooling purposes. Alright, now some of the biggest producers of solar energy are like Germany, China, US, Japan and Italy. Now in India, if we see, the major solar parks are found in Gujarat, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. Alright, now next we have, that is the tidal energy. So let's see what's this tidal energy. Now the energy of ocean tides can be tapped to produce electricity. Now this is known as tidal energy. Now it's used to turn the turbines and generate electricity during these high tides. Okay, now electricity from this source is generated in France and to some extent in UK and Russia. Now, do you know children, another important information, that is France was the first country to build the tidal energy station. Alright, and in India if we see, this tidal energy is harnessed in the Gulf of Kutch. Okay, so let's see. Next we have, that is the nuclear energy. Now the energy that is stored in the nuclei of atoms of naturally occurring radioactive elements like uranium and thorium, so this is basically known as nuclear energy. Alright, now this energy is further used to generate electricity. Now if we see, the countries that generate nuclear power are Japan, Germany, Russia, France, Sweden, Canada, Australia and Spain. Same way, if you see in India, the main nuclear power generating stations are at Tarapur, Kalpakkam, Rawatbhata, Narora, Kakrapar and Kota, which is located in Rajasthan. Alright, so these are the places. Now next we have, that is the geothermal energy. Alright, so what is this geothermal energy? Now the energy obtained by using the heat of the earth is known as geothermal energy. Now let's see the procedure. So two holes are basically drilled deep inside the earth, and when water is pumped through one hole, steam comes up from the other. Now this steam is used to generate electricity. Alright. Now, sometimes this heat energy surfaces itself in the form of hot springs. Now, if we see, for example, the largest geothermal plants can be found in the USA, New Zealand, Iceland, Philippines, and Central America. Likewise, if we see in India, geothermal plants are located in Manikaran, in Himachal Pradesh, and Puga Valley, that's in Ladakh. Alright, so these are the places where these geothermal energy, geothermal plants are located. Next, we have that is biogas. Now, biogas, basically organic waste such as dead plants and animal materials, animal dung, and kitchen waste, all these are converted into a gaseous fuel, and this is called biogas. Alright, now this biogas is used for lighting homes, alright, and cooking also. And biogas plants are common in India, in most of the rural areas. Now, use of biogas is also prevalent in China. Understood? Now, as we have discussed about all the different non-conventional power resources, so it's quite natural that we discuss about its conservation. So when we talk about the conventional and the non-conventional power resources, all these resources, so the most important thing that we need to keep in mind, that is how to conserve these power resources. Alright, now continuous consumption of conventional sources of energy may lead to their exhaustion. This is quite natural. Now therefore, we should use them judiciously and economically. Alright, now the following steps should be taken to save the resources. First we have, that is efficient utilization of resources. Alright, efficient utilization of resources. So we must check how much is needed. We shouldn't use it like extra, we shouldn't like waste it. Second we have, that is minimizing the use of fossil fuels. Yes, we, as much as we can, we should minimize the use of fossil fuels. Alright, as it takes a long time to like produce. Now, thirdly we have switching off electrical appliances to save power. Yes, when the electrical appliances are not in use, we should check that these are switched off. So when you are not at home, you should switch off the fans, lights, everything. Alright, so in this way we can save power. Next we have recycling of resources. Yes, the resources that can be recycled, so we should go for it. Alright, and we should focus in all these alternative sources of energy. Next we have improving the techniques of extraction and purification. Now, as we have like discussed earlier, the different extraction process and how it's purified, so we should check here and improve different techniques. Alright, so that while extracting and purification, the percentage of it doesn't get waste. Most of the percentage. And lastly, this is like very important one, that we should focus on using all these alternative sources of energy and its substitute, like solar energy, wind energy, all these things we should focus in using and utilizing all these sources of energy. Now, India is said to be one of the 7 largest consumers of energy, but even today, India is like dependent on other nations to meet its energy demands. Okay, so we should focus like how we can do this improvisation and uplift our country. Okay, so that's all we have in this session. I hope you have liked it. So until the next time, bye bye.